Ep3 Pt2 Submachine Guns. This video will give you a basic introduction to submachine guns in COD 4. The first thing you need to know is that submachine guns have a specific purpose. The point in a submachine gun is not to worry about accuracy or range. SMGs work a little like shotguns. They inflict multiple wounds on close quarters targets. However, unlike a shotgun, multiple targets. As such, my recommended class for any submachine gunner is pick whatever perk you like in slot 1, take stopping power and steady aim for the second and third perk. You're going to be hip firing a lot, so steady aim is very useful. There's a style of play that you'll learn for subbies, I call it behind enemy lines. Soon you'll figure out why for yourself. That said, let's get on with it. First of all, we've got the MP5. Now, the MP5 is a very mobile and agile weapon, and the bullets kick out quite a lot of damage versus the rate of fire that you've got. It's got a fair amount of range to it, but as you'll learn with most submachine guns, which I'll go into in a bit more, you're going to be using this elusive word called hipfire. Basically, if you come up against multiple targets like you did then, you don't have to bother aiming down the sights. You can literally just shoot the gun. Steady aim will get you a lot more accuracy when it comes to this particular style of play. With a submachine gun, because of the way you're going to need to play, I'd recommend it. Highly recommend it. The MP5 can be quite accurate over a distance if you use controlled burst fire shots, but really what you want to do is try and stick to an area with a lot of twisty turny corridors where people are going to come sprinting through like idiots, and you can just take them out without aiming down the barrel before they can shoot you. Now you'll see just there that I had multiple targets and I decided to shoot the one on the floor like a complete idiot. When it comes to using submachine guns, you need to be pretty good at deciding which target to take out first, because the idea of the submachine gun is you're going to be coming against multiple targets on a regular basis and you want to come out alive. The way to decide which target to go for is which one can see you, which one can do the most damage to you. So for instance, if you're coming up to two targets behind one guy but the other guy is looking at you, take out the guy that look at you. If you come up to two targets, one on the floor in last stand, take out the guy who's not in last stand, because the guy with the pistol isn't going to do as much damage to you. Ultimately, back out, let the guy standing up run around the corner, kill him, then go and take the last stand guy. You've got to be able to think on your feet and you've got to think fast. Then we've got the Scorpion. This is fast, deadly, and oddly enough, can be used to snipe. The reason I say that is the iron sights are very accurate on this. If you've got someone trying to snipe you, you can use the iron sights to take out their sniper as long as you're taking nice controlled, steady burst firing shots. The Scorpion has got a higher fire rate and is more accurate than the MP5. It does the same amount of damage as the MP5, but the range isn't as good, so your hip firing has got to be a lot closer to the enemy. And also, it's got an incredibly small clip. That being said, it's a very deadly weapon. Another tip for a submachine gun class is to be very offensive with your playstyle. You want to be in amongst the enemy, running around the enemy. Because you're hip firing instead of looking down the barrel, you can literally run circles around any opponent you come across. If they've got an assault rifle, they're going to have to look down the barrel to make sure they're going to get a decent shot up on you. You can already be behind them and onto the next guy. You've got to bear this in mind when using any submachine gun. Keep moving, keep agile, keep fast. Then we've got the Mini Uzi. The Mini Uzi, again, is super fast. Super fast gun. The bullets come flying out of the end of it. You've also got a decent clip. It means if you miss, don't fret, don't worry. You've still got some ammo left. Similar to the AK-47 of the assault rifle class. What I like about this gun is it literally it's multiple target exposure. You can spin around like a maniac if you've got it. It's got such a large clip for a submachine gun versus the amount of damage it does, and it's even got a fairly decent range with its blind fire. You should be able to get quite a few headshots with this, but remember, when it comes to submachine guns, you're not aiming for headshots. Bit more on a submachine gun. You want to be in amongst the enemy. I've said it a couple of times. That's because that's where you can cause the most damage. As a submachine gunner, your goal is to stop the enemy getting any kind of support. You don't want them to have a UAV, you don't want them to have an airstrike, and worse, you don't want them to have a helicopter. As a submachine gunner, you are fast. You can get to places before anyone else can. You can keep shooting and keep running. This makes you an incredibly deadly weapon against the enemy. Now, the hard part is, if you're in amongst the enemy and one of your teammates dies, they start spawning near to you and start drawing attention to you. The reason I've got a silencer but not a UAV jammer is because you need to do a lot of damage to a lot of targets very fast, but the silencer stops them pinpointing you. UAV jammer, even if they know you're coming, they're not going to pinpoint you, so you can still deal with them if they see you first. Hopefully you don't get seen. Hopefully if you're doing your job right, the enemy's not getting in your UAV. You can become a one-man army when using a submachine gun. However, team play is important. If you've got two forefront submachine gunners, you're going to beat nearly anyone you come across, as long as they're flanking properly. Which leads us on to the next gun, which you're probably be a bit familiar with already, which is the AK-74U. This is a close quarters version of the AK-47. That being said, its range isn't quite as nice as the AK-47. It's still got a decent clip size and a comparatively low rate of fire compared to the rest of the submachine guns, but it does a phenomenal amount of damage. If you slow down a little bit with this one, yes, still running, still try to get around behind the enemy, flank them as much as possible, keep the silencer on it so that when you shoot they don't all suddenly turn around towards you, keep your stopping power on, because the damage amplified on this gun, trust me, is a force not to fight. But take your time a bit more. You might want to slow down because it's not as agile when it comes to multiple targets, unfortunately. Otherwise the gun would be very overpowered. However, if you compare it to its assault rifle counterpart, it's still good, it's still accurate, and it can still deal with a few targets at once, as long as you've got the upper hand on the situation, i.e. you flank them and they don't know that you're there. Right. Talking a little bit more about how to be a submachine gunner, it works best in a team strategy if you've got a couple of submachine gunners, one to watch each other's back. The problem when you're submachine gunning is you'll have one guy running about, running right into the midst of the enemy, killing as many as you can before he dies, aiming for a 3-1 KDR. Every time you die, you need another UAV. Have another guy watching his back if you can. He doesn't have to be in amongst the fight quite so much, but just keeping guys off his back. That means you've got a submachine gunner doing two important tasks: providing air support and taking their air support away. That's the way to be a submachine gunner. Then you've got the P90. Deadly, fast, powerful, accurate, and deadly. Very deadly. It doesn't take all that much skill to use a P90. I have to admit it, I use the P90 myself when it comes to a game where I need to win, because it's so easy to use. The clip is huge. What is even bigger though is the rate of fire. The bullets come flying out of this like a rocket. This is the equivalent to sitting on a shrapnel bomb. You're going to get ball bearings everywhere. It's accurate if it needs to be, it's agile, the damage, the speed is phenomenal. Once you've got this, you may not like it at first, but if you get used to hip firing, you'll take out anyone who comes in your way. You deal more bullets than any other gun in the game. You deal it at close range to medium range. You can take out long range people with this gun, but you're going to be standing still while you do it, which is the opposite of what you need as a submachine gunner. Keep moving, keep firing, keep agile. This was Can You CoD It Episode 3 Part 2, Submachine Guns. Big thanks from me, Smeep, of Smeep Productions and smeep.me.uk. Clan VRM as well. Everyone else on my friends list. Yes, that includes you, Pezza, and that includes you, Pro Evolution. Other than that, guys, thanks for watching and have a great time.